We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello friends, I'm Dr. Chetan Kumar Patel, working as an associate professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at SNPIT RC Umrak. I'm going to teach steam boiler chapter in basic mechanical engineering subject. So first of all, definition of the boiler. So boiler is a closed vessel used to create steam at desired pressure and temperature by applying heat energy to water through combustion of fuel, and this heat is transferred to water for its conversion into steam. It must follow the Indian Boiler Regulation Act 1923. According to Indian Boiler Regulation, a boiler is a closed pressure vessel with capacity exceeding 22.75 liters for generating steam under pressure. This kind of boiler must have a mountings fitted which is necessary for the safety of the boiler. A boiler is utilized for generating steam for power generation and hot water for heating purpose. So now, classification of boiler. Boilers may be classified in various categories. So first of all, horizontal, vertical, or inclined boilers. So if the axis of the boiler is horizontal, then it is called as horizontal boiler. Examples are Lancashire boiler and locomotive boiler. If the axis of the boiler is vertical, then it is called as vertical boiler. Example is Cochran boiler. And if the axis of the boiler is inclined, then it is called as inclined boiler. Now, second category is fire tube boiler and water tube boiler. So the boilers in which the hot gases are inside the tubes and water is surrounding the tubes, then it is called as fire tube boiler. Examples are Cochran, Lancashire, and locomotive boiler. Water tube boiler, the boilers in which the water is inside the tubes and hot gases surround them is called as water tube boiler. Examples are Babcock-Wilcox boiler and Stirling boiler. So, now next category is externally fired boiler and internally fired boiler. So if the boiler if the fire is outside the shell, then this kind of boiler is called as externally fired boiler. Example of it is Babcock-Wilcox boiler. And in the boiler, if the furnace is located inside the boiler shell, then it is called as internally fired boiler. Examples are Cochran boiler and Lancashire boiler. Next category is forced circulation and natural circulation boiler. If the circulation of water is done by pump, then this kind of boiler is called as a forced circulation boiler. Examples are Velox boiler, Lamont boiler, and Benson boiler. If the circulation of water takes place due to the difference in density, resulting from difference in temperature, then this category is called as a natural circulation boiler. Examples are Lancashire boiler and Babcock-Wilcox boiler. Next classification is high pressure and low pressure boiler. So if the working pressure of the boiler is more than 25 bar, then this kind of boiler is called as a high pressure boiler. Examples are Babcock-Wilcox boiler. If the working pressure is between 3.5 to 10 bar, then this kind of boiler is called as a low pressure boiler. Examples are Cochran and Cornish boiler. If the working pressure is between 10 bar and 25 bar, then this kind of boiler is called as a medium pressure boiler. Examples are Lancashire boiler and locomotive boiler. Next category is on stationary boiler and portable boilers. So the boilers which cannot be transported easily from one place to another are called as a stationary boilers. Examples are Lancashire boiler and Babcock-Wilcox boiler. Portable boilers are the boiler which can be easily transported from one place to another. An example of this kind of boiler are locomotive boiler, single tube boilers and multi-tube boilers. So boiler having only one fire tube or water tube, this kind of boiler is called as a single tube boiler. Cornish boiler is the example of single tube boiler. The boiler having two or more fire or water tubes for the circulation of hot gases or water are called as a multi-tube boiler. Lancashire boiler, locomotive boiler, Cushion boiler and Babcock-Wilcox boiler are the example of multi-tube boiler. So now next is the Cushion boiler. So this is the figure of Cushion boiler. Characteristics of the boiler, this kind of boiler is, it is a vertical boiler, it is a fire tube boiler, it has natural circulation of water, it is internally fired and it is not portable. Now we are going to the construction of this kind of boiler. So it consists of a vertical cylindrical cell. This is a vertical cylindrical cell, and at the bottom of this cylindrical shell there is a firebox is provided. Inside this firebox, grate is provided. This is the grate, and below this grate there is an ash pit is provided. On upper side of this grate, coal is supplied by opening the fire door. Fire door. Now, at the top of the firebox, there is a short flue pipe is provided. So hot gases when passes through this flue pipe, then there is a considerable increase in its velocity. And now this is the combustion chamber. So on the one side of the combustion chamber, a fire brick lining is provided, and other side of it, fire tubes, multiple fire tubes are provided. So when hot gases come to the combustion chamber, due to this fire brick lining, there is a deflection of hot gases, and because of this deflection, hot gases are passed through these fire tubes. After passing through the these hot gases through this fire tube, it comes to the smoke box, and from smoke box these waste gases are going to the chimney, and from chimney it goes to the atmosphere. Now we are going to understand the mountings of the boiler. So first of all, this is the blow of cork. Blow of cork is necessary to empty the boiler and remove the impurities. Now next is a feed check valve. So feed check valve is to feed the water inside the boiler. Next is the pressure gauge. So pressure gauge read the steam pressure inside the boiler. Water level indicator is also there. This is the water level indicator. So water level indicator is utilized to find out the water level in the boiler. Next is the safety valve. So safety valve is utilized for the boiler safety. Manhole is provided for a periodic inspection. This is the fusible plug, and fusible plug is provided to save the boiler when the water level is below the certain level. At that time, this fusible plug material is melt and it fall down, and because of that, burning of coal is stopped. Another important mounting provided here is the steam stop valve. From steam stop valve, steam is supplied at the necessary place. And this is a anti-priming pipe. Anti-priming pipe is provided to separate suspended moisture and allow the dry saturated steam through this steam stop valve. Now, working of this Cushion boiler. So in this kind of boiler, first water is fed into this boiler through feed check valve, and coal is added to the grate through the by opening the fire door, and after place the coal inside the furnace, coal is burnt. So because of this burning of coal, hot gases are produced, and these hot gases passes through this narrow passage of a flue pipe, and because of that there is an increase in velocity of hot gases. When hot gases enter inside the combustion chamber, hot gases deflects, and because of this deflection, it passes through these fire tubes. When hot gases passes through these fire tubes, it transfer its heat from hot gases to the water, and because of that evaporation of water taking place, and because of this evaporation, steam is generated, and generated steam is collected at a steam space. After hot gases after passing through these fire tubes come to the smoke box, and from smoke box it releases to the chimney, and from chimney it goes to the atmosphere. So when steam is collected at steam space, it is supplied to the necessary place by utilization of steam stock valve. And now this is the figure of Lancashire boiler. Some of the characteristics of this kind of boiler is, it is horizontal boiler, it is stationary boiler, it is a fire tube type boiler, it has natural circulation of hot gases, and it is a medium pressure boiler. Now you can see the construction of this Lancashire boiler. There are three views are provided here in this figure. One, this is a front view of the boiler, this is a side view of the boiler, and this is a top view of the boiler. You can see that there is a cylindrical cell is provided, and cylindrical cell is supported by this construction of this brick. So you can see that in this Lancashire boiler shell is made of steel plates, and the steel plates are of 10 to 12.5 mm in thickness. The cylinder this cylindrical shell is placed above the brick structure. Now the brick structure provides for certain channel. You can see this is a cylindrical shell, and it is supported by this brick structure arrangement, and this brick structure is provided to pass the hot gases. Just like you can see here it is a provided bottom passage, and here you can see it is a provided side passage. So the brick the channel made at the bottom of the shell is called bottom flue pipe, and the sides are called side flues. So you can see this is a bottom flue passage, and this is these are side flue passage. So inside the boiler, two furnace tubes are known as main flue pipes. All the space of the boiler shell surrounding this furnace tubes is surrounded by water. So you can see that these are the main flue pipe, which is a decrease in diameter, and it is surrounded by water. So grate is provided at the front end of this furnace tubes, and the coal is placed at the grate, and after that coal is burnt, coal is added to the grate through fire hose. So you can see these are the grate which is provided inside the furnace. Okay, and on the grate a coal is supplied, and after that this coal is burnt. Another is a furnace doors and damper doors. So furnace doors and damper doors are placed at the beginning and at the end of the fire tube. So here you can see this is the furnace door, and these are the damper door. These two doors are the damper doors. So furnace doors control the air entering at the front and damper doors control it at the rear. So these furnace door at entering the furnace is controlling the air at front side, and this is a damper is controlling the air at the rear side. Fire brick arc at the end of each grade, a fire brick arc is built to reflect the path of hot gases so that they pass through this horizontal main flue tube. This arc also stops the entry of unburned coal or ashes into the fire tubes. So you can see here that at the end of grate, this arc is provided. So because of this arc, it stops the unnecessary supply of this coal into the main flue tubes. Now we are coming to the working part of this kind of boiler. So you can see that flue gas pipes are reduced in diameter at its back end so as to provide access to the lower part of the boiler. So you can see here that at the rear end it shows that here diameter is more, but when it reached to the end it is a decrease in diameter so that it provide a passage to the lower part of the boiler. So when coal is burnt here, after that hot gases passes through this main flue pipe, and after that it come to the this lower part of the boiler, and this hot gases passes through this lower flue pipe. We can it also called as a bottom flue passage. So flue gases from the grate passes through the main flue gas pipe, and then it passes down to the bottom flue pipe. These flue gases move to the front in the path provided by the shell and the brickwork. At this junction, these gases divided into two parts and flow through the side flue along the shell in the direction towards the back end of the shell. So you can see here that initially these hot gases passes through this main flue pipe, and after that it goes down it, and after that it passes through this bottom flue passage. When it comes to the extreme left side here, at that time two more passages are open. These are seen in top view. So it is divided into two parts, and after that it passes through this side flue passage. So in the shell there are two large horizontal flue gas pipes running parallel and passing through it. This pipe provides heating surface on the main shell. Each pipe has a grate towards the front end of the shell supported by brick arc. Below the grate is the ash pit, and the water surrounds these pipes. From the side flues, the flue gases enter in the main flue, from where they are taken into the chimney. So you can see after passing through this side flue passage, it enter into the chimney, and from chimney hot gases enter into the atmosphere. So you can see here that dampers are provided at the end of the side flue pipes to control the flow of air, which also controls the rate of generation of steam. The dampers can be opened or closed as required with the help of damper chain. So you can see here that this is the damper are provided. It is provided to control the flow of hot gases inside this boiler. So when there is a generation of steam is more, then and if we need to control the steam generation rate, at that time we open or close the damper according to the requirement. This boiler is also provided with a blow of coke at the bottom of the front end of the shell for taking out mud of the shell and for emptying the shell. It is also provided with a feed pipe and feed check valve for feeding water to the boiler at a uniform rate. So this is provided with a blow of coke at bottom side to empty the boiler when it is necessary, and this is also provided with feed check valve to feed the water inside the boiler. So these are the necessary mountings for this boiler. So basically this is a fire tube boiler. So with this, it is the end of this working of Lancashire boiler. Now next is a Babcock Wilcox boiler. Characteristics of this boiler is it is a horizontal boiler, it is a water tube boiler, it is a externally fired boiler, it is stationary boiler, and it has natural circulation of water. Now we study construction and mounting arrangement in this kind of boiler. Here you can see it is a cylindrical shell is provided, and after that cylindrical shell there are several water tubes are provided, and this is uptake header and this is downtake header. So these tubes are connected with the cylindrical shell with this uptake header and downtake header arrangement. In addition to that, you can see here that here also a furnace is provided and a grate is provided on which a coal is placed. Below this grate, ash pit is provided. On the right side of the boiler, a damper arrangement is provided to control the flow of air in this kind of boiler. Damper is connected to the chimney so that hot gases are passes through this chimney and entered inside into the atmosphere. Now we can see inside this boiler, there are several very important arrangement is provided. This is called as a baffles. So baffles are basically provided so that hot gases during the movement, it moves in the sine wave form so that it cover maximum area of the water tubes during its movement. And after that, it after finishing this sine wave movement of hot gases, it leaves this boiler. So now we can discuss another necessary mounting with this boiler. Here you can see pressure gauge, which is utilized to read the steam pressure inside the boiler. Another is a water level indicator to see the water level inside this boiler. Another thing is the safety valve. This safety valve may be a dead weight safety valve or lever loaded safety valve. This is utilized when steam pressure level is above the certain level at a time. It releases the pressure, its pressure through this safety valve. Stop valve is provided so that steam generated here is supplied to the necessary place like steam turbine. Here superheater is also provided. So superheater, you can see here, superheater is provide because superheater superheat the steam, and after that it this superheated steam supplied to the steam turbine. This superheater takes heat from these hot gases. So now we are coming to the working of this boiler. The water is fed into the boiler shell through the feed check valve. Due to the gravity, water passes through these vertical tubes, headers, and fills up inclined tube first. The water then collects in the boiler shell. The water level in the shell is adjusted with the help of water level indicator. So first of all, we feed the water through this feed water inlet valve, and when water is enter inside this cylindrical shell, at that time It fills first the this bottom area. So first of all, these water tubes filled, and after that these headers are filled with water, and after filling these header part, the water is filling this cylindrical shell space. Now coal is put on the trolley gate and the coal is fired. The trolley is then pushed into the fire space. So first of all, this trolley is outside and we fire this coal, and after that we entered this platform inside the boiler. In order to provide air for combustion of coal and circulation of hot gases, damper is lowered to the furnace level. The baffle plates do not allow hot gases to the right side. These gases hit the superheater and then move down. These gases travel in the sine wave from and then move to the smoke box fitted with a long chimney. So you can see here that after combustion of this coal, hot gases are generated. When these hot gases are generated, due to this baffles arrangement, it is these hot gases not directly goes to the damper and enter into the chimney, but it passes through these baffles arrangement, so that it moves like it is. This movement is like a sine wave movement to cover the maximum part of water tubes, as well as also it also covers the superheater. And after finishing this sine wave movement, it enters into the chimney. So water in the upper portion of the tube is heated and rises up. The cold water from downtake header rises to take its place, and water from the boiler drum flows down. So what happened here, that water in this area is heated first, and after that, because of this water is heated, its density is decreasing, and because of decreasing density, this water is enter inside the boiler, and to take this space, water in the lower part of these tubes came to the upper part, and when it reaches here, there is some vacant space here. So water is came to the here, and there is a natural circulation of water is taking place. So thus the natural circulation of water takes place just by placing the water tube at an angle of 5 degree to 15 degree with the horizontal. So you can see here, because of to get this natural circulation of water, it is placed 5 to 15 degree angle with the horizontal. Till the temperature of water in the tube and in the drum becomes uniform, the circulation of water continues. Finally, the water in the upper portion of the tubes is converted into steam, and it is then collected to the boiler shell. So because of this arrangement, natural circulation of water taking place, and water is moves like in clockwise direction. The sine wave movement of the hot gases enables contact with the maximum surface area of water tubes. The maximum amount of heat is transferred to water from the hot gases. The steam is collected above the surface of water in the drum is waste steam. So whatever the steam collected here is the waste steam, and we cannot provide this waste steam to the steam turbine. So because of this requirement of dry or superheated steam, a superheater is provided. So we pass this steam to the superheater, and after that superheated steam is provided to the steam turbine by steam stop valve. So the steam is collected above the surface of water in the drum is wet steam. The superheater is used to convert this wet steam into superheated steam. This superheated steam is then taken out through the steam stop valve fitted on the top of the boiler for different uses. With this, I finished the discussion of boilers.